PowerDirector 19 has a new vertex point feature in the mask designer. This allows you to create custom masks so you can snatch any object out of a video. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a custom video mask for your videos. So let's do like Halloween and get our mask on. As you can see, I have a festive photo in the timeline celebrating Thanksgiving. Let's all give thanks for what we have. I want to add this smiling woman over that clip so that we can go ahead and add to the joy and wonderment of the holiday season. But in order to do that, I need to get this woman to the timeline. I'm going to place my cursor over this woman. I'm going to hold down my left mouse button and drag this down to the position where I want the woman to show up on the screen. And now this clip is too long, so I want to trim this down to size. I'm going to place my cursor at the end here until I see two arrows pointed in the opposite direction. I'm going to hold down my left mouse button. I'm going to drag this down to the duration I want. And let go of my mouse, and now it is all trimmed down. Now, I'm going to click on this, and I'm going to click on the home button on my keyboard because I want to make sure that the playhead is at the beginning of this clip. Now I need to create a custom mask to get rid of the white and show the picture underneath. So I'm going to go up here to Tools, and then I'm going to go to Mask Designer. Now, if the object that you want to mask out is small, you have this button up here, this zoom in button. You can click on that, make things larger. But I don't need this for this. This woman is the perfect size for me. So now I want to make sure that I select Mask Properties by clicking on this carrot. And then down here, you will see a button that says create a custom selection mask. So you want to left click on that. And right now I can see the woman and I can see the picture underneath. I don't want to see both of them. So if you're like me and you just want to see what you're going to mask out, go down here and click on this little box that says only show the selected track. And now all we can see is the woman that we're going to mask. So at this point, you just want to start adding your points by clicking on the image and selecting the piece that you just want to keep. Now, at this point, if you make a mistake, you want to remove a point, you can just right click on it and choose remove point. You can also click on the undo button. Or you can do Control Z on your keyboard. Any of those will remove any mistakes that you make. So now you just want to keep on going around here and clicking on the points. Once you have all your points, all you got to do is click on the first point to go ahead and connect them. And voila, mask completed. Well, not really completed. But you're halfway home. Now, if you make any mistakes, you can also remove points from here as well. You can just go ahead and right click on any one of these points. And you can remove it. If you place your cursor over a point until you see a little hand, you can actually grab it and move your points. So if you want to move them, you made a mistake, you can move them around. As you can see, two little filled in squares got created when I left click on that point as well. Well, these can be used to create curves. So if I go ahead and grab one of these, I can create a curve to make it smoother. So if I wanted to curve around her shoulder here, I could do that. I could click on this one here, create another curve to help bring it around. Beautiful, curvy, curvalicious. Now, you can add more points if you like just by clicking. You can add additional points. It's all good in the hood. If there's movement in your video, you can keyframe the position of your mask. So if I move forward a keyframe here, right now you don't see any difference, but if you keep moving, you might start to see some white around the border of the mask. So I'm starting to see some white up here and a little bit of white down here. So if I wanted to, I could place my cursor over this red dot and I could drag it to a new position to try to cover up those spaces. Now, another option that I have is I can keyframe all of the points so that it just stays over the object where I want it. So I could just move these points so that I don't see the white anymore. Then you can move forward another frame and keep making adjustments like that. Now keep in mind, that's going to take a long time because you're going to be moving a lot of points depending on how precise you were, but it's going to give you the best looking result in the end. Once you're done adding all of your keyframes, you can go ahead and help blend in the video with the background by using feathering. So you want to go up here to your feather radius and you want to change it to what you want. I'm going to make mine a 4. That just makes the edges softer so that it blends in better to the picture that it's on top of. And at this point, you can go ahead and click on OK. And you can see what it looks like. There's a little bit of space down here at the bottom. Not really feeling that too much. So what I want to do is go ahead and change the position so that I can make sure that it's exactly where I want it to be. So I'm going to double left click on this clip to open up the pip designer. And for the X, I'm going to move it over 0.7, just move it over to the left so I can see the words. And then for the scale, I'm actually going to scale this up a little bit so that she fills out the screen a little bit better. So we're going to go to 1.125 and hit enter. And then let's go ahead and also bring this down a little bit. So you can use the buttons like I'm using, you could just drag it. You could do it however you want. I like using the buttons. It just makes it a little bit more precise here. All right. And now that I have her in the position that I want, I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. And we can play this back and see what the wonderfulness looks like. Custom mask all up in that you fill in the blank. If you like what you see, I'll leave some links to buy PowerDirector in the video description. I know you want more PowerDirector love, so be sure to click on these videos to watch more of my content and smash my cartoon face to subscribe. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.